them.
Well, Shelley, prosecutors say Roland Dow resented Jessica Linscott's son James because he had to be responsible for the boy even though he wasn't his, and because James emulated his biological father who had passed away. They say Dow hated anything connected with this late boyfriend and referred to James as Linscott's, quote, crackhead son. Court documents say when Roland Dow hit Jessica Linscott's three-year-old son James, he did it so hard the boy would go flying. And any time he was alone with James, the youngster would come away with bumps and bruises. When DCYF launched an investigation, prosecutors say the abuse escalated. When James would wet his pants, Dow would throw him in the shower, forcing him under the spray, which terrified the boy. Dow also, quote, started to tie James up when he took a nap and when he went to bed for the night. The defendant rolled James up in his blanket and tied him to his bed. At this point, the boy started having accidents. Quote, approximately 2 weeks prior to James's hospitalization, the defendant moved James's bed into the bathtub and James was forced to sleep there every night. The court paperwork says as the physical abuse grew more violent, the boy began to exhibit seizure-like symptoms. Dow, quote, would hit James in the head and say things like, James, stop, stop right now. At one point, Jessica tried to call an ambulance. The defendant grabbed the phone out of Jessica's hand and told her she was being an idiot. During one of these seizure-like episodes, the defendant pulled James out of the tub and dragged him by his feet into the living room where he spun James around on the floor. This brutality lasted about 2 months until Dow and Linscott abandoned a burned and battered James at Exeter Hospital and fled to Florida, where they were later arrested at Universal Studios. Jessica Linscott is a key witness for the state. Prosecutors say she did not come forward to report what was happening to her son because she, too, was the victim of abuse, including non-fatal strangulation and threats to, quote, slit her throat when she tried to leave Dow. Reporting live in the newsroom, Adam Sexton, WMUR News 9.